إن شاء الله we're going to talk about the beginning of سورة المزمل. Everybody knows سورة يقرأ المزمل قم الليل إلا قليلا نصفها أو ينقص منه قليلا أو زد عليه ورتل القرآن ترتيلا. This سورة one of the first سور. And when I say the first سور does not mean that the whole سورة was revealed at the same time. You understand this? The beginning of the surah was one of the surah that was revealed early in with the wahy. So the first surah that was revealed, as you all know, that was revealed in the cave the Hira, is the beginning of surah Iqra. Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. This is what happened. And then after this just little bit of Surah Al-Qalam and then Surah Al-Muzzammil and Al-Muddathir. Okay? Now there is a big dispute between the ulama which one was revealed first. Ya ayyuhal Muzzammil, Ya ayyuhal Muddathir. Because the two beginning is actually more or less the same thing. Okay? We would go, we can argue this for 2 hours. But because we do not have 2 hours, we will go with the idea that the Ayyuhal Muzzammil was first. But again, I want you to understand that the beginning of the surah, we talk about the beginning of the surah, okay? Not the whole surah. Because if you look at this, the beginning of the surah and the end of the surah probably was there was a big, you know, difference in time between them. But inshallah, we're going to talk about this. So Surah Al-Muzzammil is Surah Makkiya, and it is one of the surah that was revealed early at the time of the Wahy. Okay? Jazakallah khair. Kamakallah. Yazid khair. 725, inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya ayyuha al-muzzammil, which is, O you who have wrapped himself up. The Prophet ﷺ was scared and he was covering himself with his clothes. Okay? And last time we talked about that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never called Sayyidina Muhammad by his name. Okay? Only called him by his name when he is talking about him, not talking to him. Okay? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only mentioned in the Quran Muhammad, Ahmad, Al-Muzzammil, Al-Muddathir, and Abdullah. Okay? So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called him Ya ayyuhal Muzzammil, it's a name that's very beloved to the Prophet. It is very affectionate way to talk to people. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala consoling him. You know when you have a little kid and he's scared, and instead of telling him, hey, come here Muhammad or Ahmad or whatever it is, you say, hey, come here, you fearful guy. You understand this? It is a beauty. You comforting him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he say, Ya ayyuhal muzzammil. You come here that you are wrapping yourself up. Okay? It's nevertheless, it's slow, shows deep love and affection for the Holy Prophet. Okay? The ulama say something I want you to pay attention to it. They say our body need to be covered, okay? But our soul and our ruh has to be naked by Allah before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to beautify and cover our bodies. But our soul and our nafs, it has to be naked, clean, clear, no artificial beautification. when I go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I wanted to go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the way I am, and I need your help. There is no وما أنا من المتكلفين, I do not pretend. So when we go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so they say human nature required garment and wrapping to protect the body. But in the spiritual world, these wrappings are useless. Okay? The soul and the ruh must stand bare and open before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the silence of the night. Okay? This is the best time, but also it has to stand naked at any time with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya ayyuha al-muzzammil. Okay? قُمِ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. One of the things I just want to mention, I am in the camp of, because I is nothing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he say in this surah, يَوْلُمْ زَمْ قُمُ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. In the other surah, يَا أَيُّهَا الْمُدَّثِّرُ قُمْ فَأَنذِرْ. And the انذار, warning, came little bit late. You understand this? And that's why people who say that this surah came first, that their proof. Of course, the other people also has also good proofs that the opposite. But like I say, we want to go with the idea, we're going to be in the camp of this was revealed first. قُمُ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ordering Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, stand at night, the vigil, the night, most of the night, except a little. If you remember in Surah Al-Isra, afterwards, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is directing the Prophet, he say, وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَتَهَجَّدْ بِهِ. Surah Al-Isra, Surah 17, Ayah 79. وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَتَهَجَّدْ بِهِ نَافِلَةً لَكْ عَسَىٰ أَنْ يَبْعَثَكَ رَبُّكَ مَقَامًا مَحْمُودًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he say, at night, during the night, wake up for tahajjud. This is extra offering on your, or extra devotion for you. It may be that your Lord will raise you to a lofty station. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise your ranking of praise and among humankind. So the closer to get to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more you stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more you do tahajjud, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he say, that is the road for you to be ranking high in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Fadali. So, should we understand here that tahajjud is not necessarily salah, because salah at that time, he didn't know how to pray like that?
Say it again?
At that time when this surah came down, he didn't know how to pray.
No, they knew how to pray. And salat al-qiyam, salat al-tahajjud was mandatory. Mm-hmm. Only tahajjud. There was no five prayers from day one. From day one, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught them how to pray, and the night prayer was a mandatory for the Prophet and the companions, and they used to pray at night. Okay, but afterwards, after al-Isra wal Mi'raj, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed the five prayers, this was no longer a mandatory thing. And it was left for people as a sunnah, to do it or not, okay? So after Isra and the Mi'raj, prayer, the night prayer was not obligatory anymore. But the Prophet ﷺ and his companions never stopped. They continue doing this. And today is a sunnah. I was gonna talk about this. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, I want you to stand up. قُمْ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. The ulama say, people who have responsibility, when you have responsibility, if you are single, you can go to work or not go to work. You understand this? But when you have responsibility, it's not only you. You have a family to take care of. Okay? So the ulama say, man cannot have influence or impact if you not personally charged. if you do not have something to change and make a fingerprint, you cannot do this. So in order for me to give, I have to earn. When I want to change things, I want to charge myself, myself. And they say, you cannot give if you do not earn. You cannot teach if you do not learn. Okay? So everything, you cannot convince people. I can come to you and talk to you how to be a pious person. But believe me, if I do not practice, my talk is theoretical. Like I'm acting in a theater. You understand this? In order for me to actually convince people to be good, I have to be good. You know when the ulama say, "Man kharaja min al-qalb dhahaba ila al-qalb." Whatever goes out of the heart, it reaches the hearts. But they say, in order for it to do this, it has to settle first here. Because in order for it to get out of the heart, that means it is in the heart. You understand this? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he say, قُمِ اللَّيْلَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. I want you to prepare yourself. There is a humongous responsibility that I want you to prepare yourself for. And the ulama say, only people who live for themselves, they might live comfortable and the least trouble. I'm living by myself, I watch TV, I do this, I sleep, I eat, whatever it is. But people, so this person, he will live and die very little. But grown-ups carry the load. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that there is a huge responsibility. I want you to get up. I want you to charge your soul. I want you to connect with me. And I want you to connect with me at certain time. Not only during the day. During the day, it's a requirement. But the best thing, we're gonna talk about this. But the Prophet, when this ayat came in, Khadija was still alive. And he looked at her, he say, "Intaha ahdu an-nawm ya Khadija." The time, the era of sleeping is gone. He knew what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala meant. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he say, we're gonna see this at the end of the surah, but the Prophet sallallahu used, look at this. "Qum al-layla illa qalila." Most of the night, I want you to be up. Not 10 minutes before Fajr. Most of the night, قُمِ اللَّيْلِ, the entire night, except very little. نصفه, يعني if you're tired, half the night. أو انقص منه قليلا, if you're more tired, يعني less than half. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that was not only for Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet ﷺ, he get the ayat, he read it, the companions digested, understand it, and this is what they do. So the Prophet ﷺ, he say, انتهى عهد النوم يا خديجة. Okay? So the ulama say, think about this. At this time, there was not really much Quran, isn't it? Very, very little Quran. Very little Quran. And they say, we have the whole Quran now. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with few ayat is asking them to stay all night long, except that, today we have what? We have the entire Quran. And the Quran is collecting dust. Okay? With the whole Quran for us, the command should be stronger for us. The words Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he say, نصفه أو انقص منه قليلا. So it was instruction, it was mandatory for the Prophet and companions for Okay, inshallah, next week we're gonna continue with the surah, bismillah.